Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Mohammed Youssef. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued Decree 84 of 2020, establishing a Bahraini Consulate General in the Moroccan city of Al Ayun. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa issued Decree 85 of 2020, restructuring the Ministry of Education as follows. The Ministry of Education will oversee: first, Director General of the National Action Charter Monument; second, Communication Directorate; third, Director General of Schools Affairs, overseeing Assistant Undersecretary for Educational Services, overseeing Director of Student Services, Directorate of Community Partnership, Directorate of Physical Education; Assistant Undersecretary for Education, overseeing Directorate of Educational Operations, District 1, 2, 3, and 4. Fourth, Undersecretary for Policy, Strategies and Performance, overseeing Assistant Undersecretary for Allied Services, overseeing Directorate of Human Resources, Directorate of Financial Resources, Directorate of Risk Assessment and Legal Affairs, and Directorate of Services, and Directorate of Information Systems. Assistant Undersecretary for Education and Learning Policies Development, overseeing Directorate of Curricula, Directorate of Education Policies and Development; Assistant Undersecretary for Strategies and Performance, overseeing Directorate of Strategic Planning, Directorate of Assessment and Performance, Directorate of Licensing and Follow-up of Private Schools, Directorate of Licensing and Follow-up of Early Schools; Directorate General of the Bahrain Training Institute, overseeing Directorate of Trainees Affairs, Directorate of Training Affairs for Engineering and Sciences, Directorate of Training Affairs for Business Management and Arts. Royal Decree 29 of 2006 on the restructuring of the Ministry of Education will be abrogated. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa has followed up on the 160-kilometer long World Championship qualifying endurance ride at the Bahrain International Endurance Village. The Batilco-sponsored race was part of the festivities marking the National Day and His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. A large number of stables and riders took part in the race. His Majesty the King was welcomed on arrival by His Majesty the King's representative for Humanitarian Works and Youth Affairs, Bahraini Royal Equestrian and Endurance Federation Honorary Chairman, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness briefed His Majesty about the participating teams, different stages of the race, and the number of riders in the fray. His Majesty welcomed all the riders who are participating in this global race and stressed the importance of the endurance sports in enhancing cooperation between the youth and riders of the world, congratulating the winners. He expressed his thanks to His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa and the organizers of the race, wishing them all success in the coming championships. Riders also thanked His Majesty the King for following up on the race, which reflects Bahrain's keen interest in promoting the equestrian and endurance sports, hailing the warm welcome, hospitality, and outstanding organization. His Highness Sheikh Nasser finished second in the 160-kilometer race, while Spanish Maria Alvarez won the world championship.
It is a pleasure for us, Your Majesty, to have these champions here.
Alhamdulillah.
No, the pleasure is for us to be in the country.
Now, in this race, the current world champion, second place, third place, and the most person who won
first
the world
place.
And again, first place plus.
Wonderful ride.
Yeah. Very nice. Yeah.
Quality, Turim, quality horses. This is the
horses
quality.
Are wonderful.
Quality, Alhamdulillah.
We prepared the horses for the world championship, and it was a pleasure to ride here in Bahrain.
It's one culture.
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah. one family.
Allah yatawwal.
Thank you. Thank you very much for being with us here.
الله يطول عمرك. الله.
His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Safriya Palace His Eminence Abdullah Al-Ghraifi to greet His Majesty the King. His Majesty welcomed him and hailed his efforts and his religious scholarly research and guidance, wishing him further success. Marking the kingdom's celebrations of its national days, His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Safriya Palace poet Muhammad Hadi Al Halwachi, who presented him with his book of poems entitled Hamadiyat, Poems Related to His Majesty the King. The book contains poems recited by poet Al Halwachi in praise of His Majesty the King on various occasions. His Majesty the King expressed thanks and appreciation to the poet, commending the efforts he has exerted in compiling his valuable collection of poems containing distinguished national poems. His Majesty praised Al Halwachi's distinguished poetic skills and interaction with various occasions, valuing highly his rich poetic experience and wishing him further success. His Majesty expressed deep pride in Bahraini poets and literary figures for their giving and contributions to enriching the poetic and literary movement in the kingdom. Al Halwachi extended sincere congratulations to His Majesty the King on the National Day and the anniversary of His Majesty's accession to the throne. He also extended thanks and gratitude to His Majesty the King for praising and appreciating him, wishing him lasting good health and happiness. Poet Al Halwachi recited a poem before His Majesty the King, marking the occasion.
وزين كل جميل خطه قلمي غنيت باسمك أبياتا مضمخة بالطيب إذ حرفها للمكرمات نمي إياك أعني بها إياك أعني بقول لست أكتمه فطيب ذكرك عبق الورد في الأكم أحلى من الشهد عندي حيث أن به خمر الحروف التي أجلو بها ألمي لولا مهابتكم عندي لما اقتصرت هذه الحروف على الإيقاع والنغم لولا مهابتكم عندي لما اقتصرت هذه الحروف على الإيقاع والنغم ولا اكتفيت ببحر الشعر منبسطا به البسيط الذي يحلو بكل فمي أطلعت شمس حروفي منذ جنتها فأشرقت باسمكم كالنار في علمي ودبت الروح في أرجاء قافيتي كما يدب دبيب البرء في السقم أنت الذي في المعالي حزت ذروتها متوج بالعلى الموسوم بالكرم وأنت من لم تجد إلا بمكرمة ولم تقل غير خير القول والحكم ولا تأخرت يوما عند مسألة من طالب حاجة أو مملق وضمي أحييت بالجود ربعا أنت عاهله ومن أتاك بأمر قط لم يضمي تعودت كفك المعطاء إن قصدت ألا تجود سوى بالعارض العرم كأنها وهي تهمي ديمة هطلت بوابل الخير منها طالت الديم تعطي القريب كما تعطي البعيد ولم تزدد سوى بعطاء غير منصرمي يا سيدي إن عندي بعض قافية أكاد أكتمها خوفا من التهم وقد علمت بأني غير مكترث إلا برأيك في بعد وفي أممي هذه عصايا التي ما زلت أحملها من أول الشعر قبل الشيب والهرم من يوم جد حفص والأيام شاهدة بأن لي مأرب في الخير لم يلمي ولي مآرب أخرى غير خافية على اللبيب الذكي العاقل الفهم أمشي بها وهي عندي ليس متكئا لكن بها أحتمي من زلة القدم لم أسعى فيها سوى بالخير محتسبا ولم أهش بها يوما على غنمي لم أسعى فيها سوى بالخير محتسبا ولم أهش بها يوما على غنمي حتى إذا ضاق بي أمر لجأت إلى حياض جودك كي أروى من الشبم فلم أجد منك إلا فيض مكرمة فنفحة منك تروي غلة النسم أما عصاي فقد ألقيتها ليروا بأن سحرهم ضرب من الوهم ألقيتها لا لكي تقتات ما صنعوا لكن أميز بها دري من الفحم وها أنا اليوم والخمسون قد ذهبت وألحقت أربعا تمشي بلا قدمي أمشي الهوينا وإيدا غير مضطرب ولم تشب من حروفي نغمة الحلم ولم أزل أتباها باسمكم أبدا في كل محتفل في كل مزدحم أنتم ربيع حروفي وهي دائمة الإزهار في القر أو في حمأة الضرم ما شاب شعري ولا شاخت حروفي إذ إكسيرها ذكركم في غيهب الظلم أنتم سناها وأنتم نور بهجتها والله لولاك لم تنطق ولم تدمي ولا تحركت فيها قيد أنملة في لجة الحرف أو في مهمه الهمم تزداد بشرا إذا حطت بساحتكم وترتقي كارتقاء النجم في السدم يا سيد الشعر إن الشعر مفخرة للمرء إن لم يحد عن خطة القيم وإن بقى دعوة للخير صادقة وحافظا لعهود الناس والذمم وذكر كل جميل منكم سمة بها يفاخر شعري كل متهم تجمل الشعر منكم إذ نطقت به ولم أصخ لكلام الحاسد البرم ولن أصيخ سوى للخير متبعا فيها خطاك التي تفضي إلى السلم فاسمع فدتك أبا سلمان قافية قد طاولت في ذراها أرفع القمم دانت لكم بجميل منك متصل وبادرت للعلا تسعى بلا سأم كأنها وهي تتلى في محافلكم ضرب من السحر لا ضرب من الكلم وما تكلفت فيها لحظة أبدا ليس التكلف من طبعي ولا شيمي عفو البيان يجيء الشعر منتظما كأنه اللؤلؤ المنضود في النظم إليك يا سيدي جاءتك صادعة بالحب لم تقترف شيئا من اللمم دمتم ودامت بك البحرين عامرة يرف بيرقها يرف فيها لواء الشكر والنعم ودمت يا سيدي عنوان نهضتها ودمت بيرقها المنصور في الأمم ودمت بيرقها المنصور في الأمم السلام
His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa issued a circular regarding the public holidays of the National Day and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. Under the circular, the Kingdom's ministries, government departments and public institutions will be closed on Wednesday and Thursday, 16th and 17th of December 2020. The representative of His Majesty the King for Humanitarian Works and Youth Affairs, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, affirmed that the Paris FC team is proceeding according to the plan set by the Board of Directors aimed at achieving the best results in the second French league. His Highness indicated that in round 15, the team tied with Rhodes AF, which will have positive impact to achieve positive results in the coming rounds. His Highness noted that the many goals made in the past period are in light of the distinctive promotion of Bahrain with the slogan Victorious Bahrain. His Highness added that the Kingdom's name on the team's shirt has many goals and is in line with Bahrain's Economic Vision 2030. His Highness wished the team success in the 16th round of the league on Saturday. The Shura Council held its weekly meeting remotely, presided over by its chairman Ali Saleh. The Council approved the first supplementary report of the Women and Child Affairs Committee regarding a draft law issuing the Correctional Justice Law for Children and their protection from abuse. The Council reviewed a draft model law on food and nutritional security in Africa submitted by the Pan-African Parliament. The Interior Ministry has followed up on the Qatari Interior Ministry's post on its Twitter account about the arrest of three sailors and the confiscation of their Bahraini boat at Fesht al-Dibel by the Qatar Border Guards and Coast Guards. The ministry highlighted that it was not notified officially about the incident by the concerned Qatari authorities, asserting that the provocative practices of Qatar are against the principles of the GCC and the neighboring ties and international norms. They also reflect the hostility of Qatar and its targeting of the livelihoods of Bahrainis. The ministry asserted its rights to take the appropriate steps to protect the rights and the rights of citizens, as the regional waters have been the source of income for local fishermen for years. The President of the Asian Football Confederation and First Vice President of the International Football Federation, Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa, received a delegation of the Saudi Arabian Football Federation headed by the Chairman of the Board of Directors of the Federation, Yasser Al Mishal, who delivered to him the Saudi file for organizing the 2027 AFC Asian Cup. Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim welcomed the delegation of the Saudi Football Federation, expressing deep appreciation for its keenness on applying for hosting the major continental event, which affirms the great position of Terminant occupies on the football scene and its growing influence in developing the outcomes of the game in the Asian continent. He expressed confidence that the increasing interest of the Asian national federations to host the Asian Cup will have a positive impact in terms of raising the value and stature of the tournament, which will positively reflect on the Asian football system. He expressed best wishes for all the federations wishing to organize the event. The President of Bahrain Football Association, Sheikh Ali bin Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, received the President of the Saudi Football Federation, Yasser bin Hassan Al Mishal, and his accompanying delegation on the occasion of their visit to the Kingdom to deliver the Saudi file for organizing the 2027 AFC Asian Cup, which will be presented under the slogan Together for the Future of Asia, as an integrated file for the Saudi Federation to host the major Asian event. The President of the Bahrain Football Association expressed his deep pride in the visit, which reflects the strong fraternal relations between the two brotherly countries. He stressed that Bahrain Football Association supports the integrated Saudi file to host the Asian finals in 2027, noting that the file has all the components for success in hosting the largest tournament for teams in the Asian continent. The National Health Regulatory Authority announced that it has officially approved the registration of Sinopharm's COVID-19 vaccine after the submission of all related documentation by G42 Healthcare. The NHRA's decision to approve and use the vaccine is based on the clinical trials data conducted across several countries, which was thoroughly reviewed and evaluated by the authority. The NHRA further verified the quality of the vaccine by reviewing the scientific data behind the manufacturing process and the stability of the product, in addition to ensuring the manufacturer's commitment to applying to principles of good manufacturing practice in accordance to international standards. The NHRA also consulted with the Clinical Research Committee at NHRA, comprised of medical specialists, researchers, academics, and doctors who are also responsible for approving clinical trials, as well as the approval of the Immunization Committee. The Ministry of Health said today that the number of coronavirus cases reached 1,529, with 158 recoveries and 145 registered new cases. 81 of the new registered cases are expatriates, 54 are contacts of active cases, and 10 are travel-related. The ministry urges everyone to adhere to the rules, follow instructions, and avoid public places when possible.